Hey everybody, welcome back to World of Tanks with Hachiman. Here I'm bringing you the first look at the new Soviet Tier 8 Premium, the IS-3A. I've got a double dose of gameplay here, which I will show you a number of different things. First thing, pausing the replay for a moment, let's just look at this tank. Well, yeah, it's an IS-3. I don't know what else to say. It does look like it might have the stock turret from the IS-3, which is still a good turret, but overall it's pretty much a standard IS-3 look. The IS-3A, which is the IS-3 auto, the idea behind this tank is not what you think. It is not an auto-loading gun. It is a pretty standard Soviet 122mm with an auto-loading assistant, essentially, so that the crew gets slimmed down to 3 guys. Now, this is an advantage in one way, that your crew XP is only divided 3 ways. On the other hand, if you're using this tank to train your Soviet heavy tank crews, most Soviet heavy tanks are 4-man tanks, so you're going to have one guy who gets left behind, and that guy is going to be the loader, someone you don't want left behind. So what this tank does, and does very well, is make a lot of money. We're watching Mr. Too Fat, he's loading up with premium consumables, 3 rounds of premium ammo, 2 HE, 23 standard rounds, and based on his reload time, which seems to be in the neighborhood of 10 seconds, I'm sure he has a tank gun rammer, maybe even vents as well. He is on Sacred Valley, of course, with a 39% chance to win. The enemy team seems to be overall better than his team. Mr. Too Fat himself is pretty good, 1192 W8, making him well above the average player over 7,000 games. And Mr. Too Fat, this tank does have a very nice model. You see the tow cables there, and even some gap between them and the chassis of the tank, which you don't see on a lot of tanks. It's a very pretty model. Mr. Too Fat's going to pretty much standard heavy tank world on this map, which is into the northwest corner. And let's speed up time a little bit to get this moving along, because again, it's pretty much standard heavy tank move. You know, looking at this tank again, it looks just like an IS-3 with all the standard IS-3 markings and weaknesses and whatnot. They say it's a little faster. I don't see much speed difference. The IS-3 itself is pretty reasonable for a Tier 8 heavy tank. So anyhow. Alright, so he's moving up, and real quick, you see that? See how that gun is pointed way up there? So what's the first thing you notice? Standard Soviet heavy tank gun depression, which is slim to none. You want to keep this tank on level ground as much as possible. He's side-scraping here, but there's nothing to side-scrape against. He's coming up on this AMX 1375. He's got the top of the turret, puts one into it. Soviet, definitely Soviet accuracy. Their guns are not rated very accurate, but they will hit those shots 9 times out of 10. Easy pen the top of the turret of the AMX 1375. As a side note, I will guarantee you that that is as low as he could point his gun. I will guarantee you that this tank gun depression is makes it completely impossible for him to have lowered the gun at the chassis if he wanted to. So there's nothing else up here, so he cruises in to see who he can hit. And just give him 400 damage, why don't you? And the T-150's dead. Got a Lerva, IS-6, KB-40A, lots of big juicy targets, do a lot of damage to. Moves up, puts an easy one into the side of the Lerva, backs off while he's reloading. And I apologize, his reload time might be closer to 12 seconds. I still think he's running a rammer. He fires and bounces that off the KV-4, couldn't get the gun low enough to get onto the lower plate, takes a hit for it. And he just continues to hang. He checks behind him to make sure that he's not flanked, and he's okay for now. And here comes the OI. He's not going to get hit by an OI. He waits till the OI shoots, peeks around, puts him right inside the drywall and the KV-4 blocks the return shot. KV-4 came too far forward, and Mr. Too Fat did not have to worry about gun depression. He's continuing to watch behind him. There's a Yog Tiger 88 back there. He starts to come around. Enemy tanks seem to have backed off, content to let Mr. Too Fat's team come around and get shot. Waits till the OI fires, comes around, and bounces one right off the upper plate of an OI. 150 millimeters of armor angled backwards, then angled at that, you know, 40-degree angle like that on impact, will bounce a shot even from a gun like this. Executes Lerva very easily, and he's clear to start turning the corner. He'd much rather the KV-4 behind him take the shot and take a hit, and that's why. Oh, look at that gun depression. He's too close to the side of the hill there, and it's tipping him upwards. He can't get the gun down. That AMX, not a great rated player, but wily enough to know he doesn't want to come out. Mr. Too Fat, I think, could get a pretty easy kill on that OI if he just moved forward and aimed low. But he's kind of holding back. He doesn't want to take the hit. IS-3 moves up and nails the KV-4. And this whole sequence in this battle was making me very anxious, because now you're flanked by an AMX-1375 who pounced off your rear and then got annihilated. But this OI in front of him should be dead by now. He should have killed this OI. And I'm just not sure why he's being so reticent. He fires at range and misses the CDC. The OI then kills his IS-3. That OI should have been long dead. And now you're down a Tier 8 heavy tank. But that's okay. Now he finally does what he should have done all along. Moves up and puts one right through the OI's gun mantling. Hitting it straight on like that, it will pen. He just had a bad angle the first time he hit it. That AMX CDC should not be back there anymore. He should have used the speed and gone somewhere else by now. Don't know what he's thinking, and I don't know why Mr. Too Fat doesn't just go murder this KV-4. KV-4 is putting himself into a corner. Bounces a shot from the CDC, gets the lower plate, and kills the KV-4. KV-85 goes charging forward because he's a heavy tank. He can kill it. Just a medium. It's a Tier 8 AMX CDC. What are you doing, man? Alright. Game's pretty even. It's 11-10. Mr. Too Fat's team's got 300 more hit points. Mr. Too Fat himself has 3 kills and 2,400 damage. He's having a very good game, though I feel like he could have pushed it a little harder, but that's okay. Moving into the enemy base. Where's that CDC? Well, the CDC finally took my advice and went somewhere else. Yeah, not gonna get... Oh, no, he didn't. He backed into the corner, and he's spamming premium ammo. There's a shocker. Mr. Too Fat just reams him. Unfortunately, the CDC's got very good DPM, and he's firing premium ammo, but he might have just gotten ammo racked, because it's taking him a long time to reload all of a sudden. Oh, yeah. CDC was definitely ammo racked. He was taking way too long to reload. So, KV-4 actually got the kill, but Mr. Too Fat had two very good shots. Now there's a Skoda T-40 who's very nearly dead, and there's a Waffenträger out there who's got pretty full hit points. It's not full, but he's got most of his hit points. Mr. Too Fat rolls into the edge of the cap circle, which I do not think is a bad play. With a T-150 protecting the base, I'd be more apt just to roll out there and see what we can find, but the KV-4 and the KV-85 are choosing to do that. And they have spotted the Skoda back at the base. T-150 should be able to handle the Skoda T-40 just fine. And there's the Waffenträger, actually in substantially worse shape than I expected based on what my team hit point mod tells me. Yeah, that's... you're not going to get that shot. That would have been a miracle to hit that shot with a Soviet 122, but now the Waffenträger is back to more exposing more of his gun shield. Of course, he moves back forward again. KV-4 just finishes him off, probably an HE shot from the way the explosion looked, and the T-150 finishes the Skoda. Mr. Two-Fat managed to earn the High Caliber Medal with 3,229 damage, 3 kills, and this was a first-class mastery badge. He made a 52,000 credit profit, even running premium consumables, which, on the other hand, though, he didn't use any of them. So, and he did not fire one round of premium ammo. He did not need to. Pretty impressive game. Let's see what part two looks like. Okay, everybody, and here we've got LeBeouf. I'm pronouncing it like the actor, first name Shia, whose only good film was Fury, by the way. And he is in his IS-3 auto in a Tier 8 matchup on Mountain Pass. Now, when we say Tier 8, this is very, very Tier 8. There are 7 Tier 8s on each team. So while this tank does not get preferential matchmaking, it does seem to get Tier 8 games a lot. But anyhow, neither here nor there. LeBeouf's team has a 53% chance to win, according to XVM, and LeBeouf himself is a very respectable player. 16-35 W8, over 10,000 battles. He's certainly better than I am. And he's going to show us what the IS-3 is really, or the IS-3A, excuse me, is really capable of. He is using standard consumables. He has 5 rounds of premium ammo, 2 HE, and 21 standard. Only 28 rounds of ammunition on this machine. Hope you don't need to shoot a lot, but with 390 average damage, shouldn't really have to. No one really covering the middle. His MT-25 is going to ditch down that way a little bit. And AMX CDC has already spotted a VK-2801. That's an easy fight for CDC. Ooh! CDC takes a full pen derp from the 2801. That had to hurt. But now the CDC should be able to kill him pretty quickly. CDC's now took another hit, and he took another hit. Oh, now shit just got real. CDC takes another big hit, probably from an IS-3 auto. That CDC got a lot more than he bargained for from that little Tier 6 light tank. And CDC says, screw you guys, I'm going home. Takes a hit from the Type 58 on the rear, and here comes an IS-3 auto. LeBeouf snapshots and nails at IS-3 auto for 396. Soviet accuracy is all I gotta say. He's got two IS-3 autos in front of him and a Type 58. This is some nasty stuff. KV-5's got a very forward position where no one's gonna be able to hurt him. Nice hit right through the upper plate of the IS-3 in the obvious weak point. Especially when IS-3 is angled at you like that, you can pen that spot. Because, real quick, that spot he just went through, if the IS-3 is facing right at you, it's angled off to the side. But if he has his side to you, if his front end is angled so that you're hitting more of his side than his front, well, all of a sudden that plate is straight ahead. And it's an easy pen at that point by even some of the 3-inch American guns. Alright, LeBeouf is showing a lot of patience. He's just waiting for a shot. He gets it, doesn't miss. And he's got his eye on this IS-3 over here. Stug 3. What is a Stug 3 doing in this game? Yeah, missed. If it had hit, pinning that would have been the shot of the week anyway. Stug 3's gone with one hit from an IS-3 auto. Oh! Snapshot on the Super Pershing, tracking him, getting penetration. This KV-5 is still holding that spot, keeping all these guys spotted. He's taking no damage. Yeah, LeBeouf takes that shot, and that shot is not going to pen at that angle. There is no way. IS-3 auto comes out again. Oh, that's a side shot, but it goes high and hits the gun mantlet for a bounce. KV-5 now starting to take some real damage. He can't hold that position much longer. He's trying to get into something more defensible. LeBeouf comes and puts a hell of a hit into the IS-3. Bounces a premium round from the Super Pershing. KV-5 is just trying to push one spot to get some cover so he can survive. LeBeouf comes in on the other IS-3 auto, hits the flat spot for the kill, and his friendly KV-5 is down. This is very evenly matched 6-6 so far, and this has been a very, very tight battle. And LeBeouf's being patient. Yeah, there you go. Good shot. If he'd fired a little more to the right, it was skated off. And he's not fired any premium yet. He's down to 11 rounds of standard ammo. Yep, there's that Type 58. Just aims right at the turret and gives it to him. Ooh, takes a hit from the IS-3 auto. But this is only the first penetrating hit he's taken. He's got a lot of hit points to give if he has to. And at this point, ooh, bounced a premium round from the Super Pershing. He does not have a good position against this enemy IS-3, though. IS-3 auto comes out too much. Oh, shot hits the spaced armor and bounces off. That's such a frustrating shot when you're fighting an IS-3, because that shot should always pen. He aims more carefully and blows right through the side of the IS-3 auto for his second kill. There's the Type 58. Type 58 bounces. That Type 58's got to figure out a new way to approach this IS-3 auto. Yep, there's that gun depression again, and that's the approach he needed, a shot straight into the side. Type 58's got a very good 85mm gun. Rear of the Super Pershing, and it bounces. That's okay, not gonna bounce this shot. Yep, easy pen, low roll, 347. Doesn't matter, he couldn't have killed him anyway. Bounces another shot from the Type 58. Super Pershing's just totally unaware of his own demise. Type 58 charges the IS-3 auto. LeBeouf just bumps into him for the kill. Does get himself tracked, but he takes no damage. Now he's got a KV-5, a Yog Tiger 88, and a Tiger P to worry about. Tiger P's an extremely respectable player. 2255 WN8. Excellent player. So he's moving up to see what kind of fire he can put on the Tiger P. This is going to be hard, though, because you have no gun depression. So you're going to have to peek down the hill. But Tiger P's busy with the Centurion. He waits for a clear shot, plants one right through the front of the Tiger P. Tiger P is now looking right at him, not even worried about the Centurion. Pens him, and he bounces. Hey, Tiger P's got 240 mil... Ooh, I derp. Tiger P's got 240 millimeters of frontal armor. It is no weakling. It's a tough, tough tank frontally, even for Tier 8. And oddly enough, the Tiger P's armor is very flat. So if you're above it firing down, which is usually an advantageous situation, because you're negating angles against the Tiger P, you're actually giving it an angle. It's kind of an interesting juxtaposition. And the Tiger P's got that very good long 88 gun, can easily pen, and there's where that shot went in, right there in the lower plate, right next to the left track. Easily pen that shot. But that's okay. LeBeouf had the hit points to give. Looking to see if he has a shot. Those guys are well behind the rocks. Now it's just a squeeze play at this point. Pincer move. The Centurion on the left. LeBeouf's going to swing around the right. The Centurion's not advancing. But that's okay. He's got their attention, and that's all he needs to do. So LeBeouf is going to flank these guys. Who does he shoot at first? KV-5 for the kill? Of course. And he bounces. KV-5 armor. Shot goes high, hits the gun mantlet, bounces off. But he's not going to miss the kill shot a second time. And there it is. Yog Tiger realized, oh crap, I'm screwed. And he's backing up, but that's not going to help. Because LeBeouf still has a side. Going for the tracking shot, gets it with a penetration. Beautiful shot. He's firing premium now because all he's got is premium and HE. And whoops. You weren't aiming at the flat spot, you're aiming at the engine deck, and it skated off. Yog Tiger is tracked. He fires a premium round at the lower plate, and it bounces. Yogg Tiger's a tough tank. You cannot underestimate it, but he's not that tough. Premium round in the side. 6 kills for the Top Gun. 4,899 damage for the High Caliber. Bounced 12 rounds for the Steel Wall. And earns himself the Ace Tanker Mastery Badge. Beautiful play. Guys, these videos, I think, showed you everything you need to know about the IS-3. Fantastic gun, Soviet accuracy, troll armor, bad gun depression, reasonable maneuverability. So then becomes the last question. Is the tank worth it? Well, if you want my opinion on the matter, Wargaming wants $59 for the bundle, American, and I'm not paying $59 for a Tier 8 premium tank. I did pay $40 for Scorpion, but I got 30 days of premium time and some gold. But for a tank that's virtually identical to the IS-3, I'll just play the IS-3. Now, that being said, LaBeouf here did earn 89,000 credits profit. Okay, it is a money maker. There's no question this tank will make money on mediocre games. It'll make a lot of money, and on great games, it'll make tons of money. But is it worth $59? Hey, if you've got that kind of money to blow, send me one as a gift. I'd love it. But beyond that, I think I'm going to pass on the $59 machine. Anyway, guys, please, I hope you liked the video. Please like it, thumbs up, comment below. And please subscribe for more. The more subscribers I get, the more I can keep making these videos. Thanks a lot, guys. See you next time.